Hi, my name is Fifi Nkum. I'm a 26-year-old entrepreneur. I'm the manager of Mogo Limited. Mogo is a transportation technology. It's an app. It's a platform that allows drivers to connect with passengers in their community. So it's an app that allows you to call for a ride if you're a passenger, and then someone in your area is able to take you wherever you want to go, with all the logistics taken care of as far as the price and the communication of the destination to the passenger and the driver. E-Taxi was in the market last two years, and they did a lot of great things. First of all, they introduced the Ghanaian market to being able to call for a ride with your phone. They also did a lot of work on the taxi driver side, sensitizing them, taking them through how the app works. So what we're doing differently is in terms of the value proposition to drivers. Obviously, we are still offering them access to more passengers, but we're also training them as far as how to set themselves about the city to be able to access requests and a lot of other things too. The Trotro app was organized by the AMA, by the Meltwater Institution, and then by the French Development Agency. Basically, what they did was map out all the Trotro routes in Accra over the course of 2 months. And then they released the data on the same day and organized a hackathon around it. And we went there over 2 days. We didn't sleep. We stayed there and then hacked through the process. And we came out with a solution that built upon what we already had, that offers schedules for Trotros and then for taxis as well, especially at peak times. So that was what gave us the prize, is that we offered a solution to all the stakeholders, from Trotros, taxis, and private users. A lot of the challenges that are coming about is traffic and the congestion, right? And that comes about because there's nothing that says that there should be this number of cars on the road. There's no quota. So you have 70% of Ghanaians using Trotro, but it occupies just 20% of the land space, while there are private vehicles taking up about 70% of the road space, but just taking care of 30% of the population. So there's some real inefficiency there that we try to tackle by spreading the number of people who are using transportation across Trotro, private cars and taxis, and then helping the AMA to be able to predict the demand. So you know that, okay, at this time, there's probably gonna be this many people calling for rides from this place. So you can schedule rides based on that demand. One of the major challenges, right, was in getting the price right. There's a certain sweet spot where the price is good enough for the driver, but cheap enough for the passenger. And it's a certain thin line that you have to tread. So we went through a couple of APIs. What we did was generate an API that was based on drivers giving us average destinations for trips, average prices for certain destinations. And then we compounded that and then put it into an API that automatically generates the price from any point in town. And so being able to communicate that to the passenger and then to the driver, and then them agreeing, and then the location being shared, and then the radius that the driver is able to receive requests in, to prevent the problem where there's a driver in Achimota receiving requests from East Legon and then having to travel all the way. So those are some of the challenges that we've managed to tackle. Ride sharing is basically being able to allow private users to get rides with others. But there's also another aspect, which is getting a taxi driver to start from a certain point and then filling up his car, which locally is known as loading. Yeah, so our app allows us to do both things, dropping and loading or ride sharing. Especially in this season, right, when it's raining and you don't want to be out there soaking wet trying to get a car, that's one of the situations when the app is most useful. You can get the ride directly to you. Another reason why you'd want to use the app is because perhaps you're in an area that you're not familiar with. You don't really know how much it's going to cost to move to that destination. We can give you an instant price quote. And then another thing is that we are able to subsidize the rides because you'll be joining someone else potentially. So you'll be moving for much, much lower, sometimes even less than a quarter of the original price. So those are the main value propositions. That's one of our major focuses, right? Making security a priority. Currently, we have an update coming up where you are able to see your mutual friends with that person. We also do a lot of background checks, making sure that the people that jump on the platform are decent, that they are not, you know, rascals that will seek to use the platform for any nefarious activities. Yes, I mean, I would be stupid not to be scared about a $62.5 billion company moving into your space, right? And they recently just raised $2.5 billion from the Saudi guys. So yeah, they don't have any problems as far as finances. They have the track record, they have the brand. But you know, I believe that there's a space for local entrepreneurs to also do something, because transportation is a huge industry, it's very segmented. And I think that Ghanaians will embrace our brand. From the very beginning, our conception was to do something for Ghanaians. So the very name, Mogo, which is Make We Go, embodies that. And I think that Ghanaians will identify with that. I went to school, Ghana Christian International. Then I went to Chicago area, to Jacksonville, Illinois. Went to Illinois College. I did international studies, psychology. I studied French and some political science as well. But I was very interested in diplomacy. I wanted to become a diplomat. But after graduating, I came home. I wanted to do my national service, and then, you know, young, vibrant guy, I wanted to make an impact at home. But one of the issues I was facing was mobility. And then being able to catch a ride with where my friends were going to and stuff like that. So I decided to start a company around increasing mobility, allowing people to be able to connect more easily. And that's how I got here. People don't believe in the market till somebody comes from outside and then comes and does the same thing. You know, you talk to people, well, ride sharing work in Ghana. For the most part, a lot of people are like, oh yeah, that's why Easy Taxi failed. You know, but there were challenges there that people didn't properly identify. They just made the broad assumption that, you know, tech can't work in Ghana, but that's totally wrong. We have a lot of tech companies that are making it big outside Ghana, even in Africa. We're talking about Soreba and other guys that are doing it big. So by all means, don't listen to what the naysayers are saying. It's not easy by any means to get people to adopt new technology, to adapt to change, but you shouldn't definitely lose hope. I think Easy Taxi failed because they didn't spend enough time in the market to succeed. You're gonna fail in the first couple of months of trying out. I mean, that's just the way technology works. It just takes a certain critical amount of time for the technology to get into the hearts and minds of people, to become everyday thing. And when you wake up in the morning, you're gonna think about using your phone to get a ride. You're gonna think first about going out onto the street to call a ride. So they needed to spend a certain amount of time to validate their market space, and they didn't do that. I think they quit too early. Another thing is that they spent a lot recruiting the drivers. They didn't get enough passengers actually fulfilling the value proposition to the ride, to the drivers. And then the team that they got, I don't think understood how to do the marketing properly. So they were going around not targeting the drivers where they listen. They were doing it in terms of a one-to-one. They weren't targeting organizations that drivers subscribe to. So that's one of the things. And then one of the other things was the logistical challenges, calling drivers from other towns, which obviously made the prices more expensive, which is one of the major things, is that it was expensive to use Easy Taxi as against the alternative. So yeah, those are the main reasons. So we're launching in July. You should be able to use the app to catch rides by then. But as I mentioned, it's gonna take a little while for you to just be able to easily just catch a ride from wherever you are. So we'll beg people to be patient with us in the first stages. We're working really hard to make it to make sure that you can catch a ride from wherever you are, anywhere from Dansuman to Pong, all the way on the other side of town. So in July, August, we'll be launching, and you can expect valuable service then.